Good afternoon, and thank you to Sophie for that seamless handover of the trophy. I can vouch for the fact that it's been vigorously wiped down with antibacterial wipes and is COVID safe, COVID secure. My name is Rick Lee and I'm the Chief People Officer for Willmott Dixon. I'd like to offer you a very warm welcome to our annual Trainee of the Year event, an event that this year, like most things this year, is very different to what we'd originally planned. Nevertheless, as with every other year, Trainee of the Year remains a very special event, a great celebration of the achievements of all of our trainees. So even though we're not at Twickenham Stadium like we'd originally planned, we hope that you can still celebrate and enjoy the event in a virtual way with colleagues and friends. I'm sure you'll know that Twickenham is the home of England Rugby, the largest dedicated rugby union venue in the world. And you'll see from our virtual event, we've kept the Twickenham rugby theme. So why did we choose Twickenham as our original venue? Well, Twickenham is a customer of Willmott Dixon Interiors, who renovated the hospitality suite in the East Stand. And I'm sure you'll agree from the images that you're about to see that the Interiors team created a fantastic venue. So what do we have planned for our virtual Trainee of the Year event this year? I can't hear you ask that question, but in a moment we'll reveal who our trainee finalists are, and we hope that wherever you are, you'll be virtually cheering for your finalist. We'll then hear from Rick Willmott, Group Chief Executive, who will talk about the trainee scheme and what it means to Willmott Dixon. Next, we're delighted to welcome Mark Robinson, Group Chief Executive of SCAPE. And he has recorded a short film for us, which will announce the SCAPE Trainee of the Year. I'll then go on to reveal who our Construction Ambassador of the Year will be, recognising the importance of all the work they do to attract new talent into the industry. And finally, we'll discover who is the Willmott Dixon Trainee of the Year. That's to come. So without further ado, let's see who our Trainee of the Year finalists are. Wow. Whether they win or not, to be nominated as a finalist is a fantastic achievement. So well done to you all, and we'll be hearing more about each of you shortly. There are also many of you watching this today who've recently graduated from your traineeships. You know, you're done and dusted, and we want to congratulate you on your achievements too. Our ambition is for everyone at Willmott Dixon to enjoy the career of a lifetime. And we look forward to seeing you all flourish as you progress your careers with us. Before I hand you over to Rick, I wanted to recognise a couple of important events that normally happen in our management trainee calendar. Most years, all of our trainees get together at our annual trainee away day. Now, the purpose of this event is to build relationships across the group that can last throughout our trainees' careers and to help everyone on the training programme to feel part of the Willmott Dixon family. At last year's event, we quickly took trainees out of their comfort zone, split them into teams, and they took part in challenges like abseiling, caving, orienteering, and archery. After a long day of activities, the trainees enjoyed a well-earned evening of street food from vans, they relaxed in the marquee, they had live music and a saxophone playing DJ. The mind boggles, but I'm told it was a great event, and let's hope we can make that happen again next year. As part of their training, our first year trainees attend the Trade Awareness course at CITB's headquarters at Bircham Newton in Norfolk. And this course helps trainees develop an understanding of building methods and to practice key trade skills such as bricklaying and joinery. Whilst COVID meant that this year's course it couldn't take place, last year Harry Pierce from London and East and Georgina Gray from the North won prizes as the most outstanding students. Well done, Harry. Well done, Georgina. I will now hand you over to Rick Willmott, who's going to talk a bit more about our management trainee programme and some of the highlights from the last year pre-COVID. Thanks, Rick.
Thank you, Rick. Well, it's been one hell of a year to be in business, and I applaud all of you for responding so professionally to the challenges thrown at us by COVID-19. Whilst none of us will want to go through the trauma of a pandemic again, we've learned vital lessons in adaptability and what it takes to remain mission-focused and operational. Out of all the meetings, functions and events in our annual calendar, today is perhaps the most important of all, as we recognise the contribution of the trainees throughout Willmott Dixon. I've said it many times before, but as an organisation, we believe that our lifeblood is our people, and particularly those who commence their careers as part of our trainee programme, or those who join early enough to consider their time with us as a career of a lifetime. It is possible, indeed likely, that some of you watching these awards will be future leaders at Willmott Dixon. In 15 to 20 years' time, after hard work, successes, knockbacks and soul-searching, one of today's trainees might indeed lead one of the largest private businesses in the UK. Now therein lies a challenge and a massive opportunity. What will set that individual apart from the rest? Well, in my book, there are a number of key traits. Judgment and instinct for calm leadership. Humility and humour. Lashings of common sense and drive. A breadth of knowledge, and perhaps most importantly, obsessive loyalty to our purpose. Interestingly, and by way of demonstrating the importance of our trainee programme, we have 77 directors across the business. 20% of those are former management trainees. That is an exceptional hit rate. Those homegrown directors have 400 years of service between them, and some of us have been friends and colleagues for almost 40 years. I hope that underlines both the importance that we place on training and career progression, but also opens your eyes to what can be achieved. So, being a management trainee at Willmott Dixon comes with responsibility. Responsibility to yourself and to the company to always give of your best, to study and to work hard to fulfill your true potential, to uphold our core values, our beliefs, and our purpose, to actively contribute to every community that you touch, and to help us to continue to be different from other companies. Above all, and it may be why you came into the construction sector in the first place, we don't just build lifeless assets, we create environments and communities. We leave a strong, enduring legacy of sustainable, exemplar facilities fit for future generations. Another important part of the management trainee programme is the annual trainee challenge in support of the Willmott Dixon Foundation. The challenge is a great opportunity for our trainees to plan and execute a project with the aim of adding value to the local community. In 2019, our trainees gave young, disadvantaged people real opportunities to learn new skills. They also created community gardens, renovated buildings, and raised much needed funds for local causes. I know that many of you will have actively supported one of these challenges, and I'd like to thank you for your contribution for the difference you have made. The overall winner of the Foundation Trainee Challenge was Hussein Izzet from Holdings. Hussein created a school-focused, fun and educational digital platform to help young people start to realise their potential. Congratulations, Hussein. We hope that in the not too distant future, we'll be able to restart these activities as soon as the world returns to some form of normality. So we're now about to announce the first of our awards, Scape Trainee of the Year. But first of all, I want to talk about Scape, what it is and why it is so important to Willmott Dixon. Next year will mark the 15th anniversary of the beginning of the Scape-Willmott Dixon relationship. This is a relationship that not only endures, but continues to strengthen as we innovate together. Scape is a public sector procurement framework established to assist public bodies to commission capital projects efficiently and in full compliance with European law. But the ambition of Scape goes much further in that it requires its construction partners to innovate, to challenge the status quo, to demonstrate sustainable credentials, to ensure the supply chain is paid on time, to invest in communities, and to train people. This is an organisation so aligned with our culture that we hope to be inseparable. The Scape Bond is one of our most prized assets. We have worked tirelessly to support and develop it to be what many customers believe to be the preeminent procurement body in the UK. If you have not worked on a Scape project or it is unfamiliar to you, please do take some time to research it and to improve your understanding. It really is that important to us as a business. The relationship with Scape is genuinely a mutually supportive one. We have a positive impact on each other's business, and that's why it is so special. So I'm now delighted to hand over to our great friend Mark Robinson, Group Chief Executive of Scape, to tell us about this year's finalists and to announce the Scape Trainee of the Year.
Hello everyone and welcome to Scape's Trainee of the Year Award. This is a very important award for me. It's something that represents the future of the industry. It's about looking at young people and seeing how they're going to develop into the future. We asked loads of good questions, mainly around Willmott Dixon and Scape's shared values, about going the extra mile for the customer, and giving us some really good examples of supporting local communities. They were all nervous during the interviews, which is usual, but they came across really well. And it was nice to see a gender balanced shortlist. So on to the candidates. The first candidate was a lovely young lady called Charlotte. Charlotte was very confident and is obviously an ambitious person. She came from a banking background originally and came into construction, which is very unusual. A community involvement work really stood out for me, and in particular, her work mentoring a young girl. That really tells me that Charlotte had the right attitude to be a success, and I'm sure she'll have a fantastic career at Willmott Dixon. The second candidate is a nice young man called Jack. Now, Jack really impressed me for all the experience he'd got for such a young age. He came across very personable and he was very easy to talk to. Jack impressed me with the knowledge and understanding of Scape and the benefits of collaboration, which is very close to my heart. He has a fantastic career ahead of him. So on to the third candidate, a lovely young man called Tom. Now, Tom really impressed me. He definitely had a determination for self-improvement. He was always pushing himself and reminded me of myself at that age. He showed a real strength of character. Now, Tom will have a fantastic career, I'm sure, at Willmott Dixon. The fourth candidate is a lovely young lady called Jordan. It was great to interview somebody from a non-operational background. Jordan obviously is passionate about the things that she does, and she had a real knowledge and intelligence around community involvement. And she obviously understood SCAPE's commitment and Willmott Dixon's commitment to social value and really delivering a legacy in the communities. I think she's a great credit to the Willmott Dixon team, and she'll have a really good future. So, on to the winner, and I'm really pleased to announce that Jack Hall is SCAPE Trainee of the Year 2020.
Thank you, Mark, and congratulations to Jack Hall from Construction North. Fantastic job, and your trophy will be on its way to you in due course. Now, moving on to our next award. One of the really important roles that all of our trainees undertake is to be a construction and STEM ambassador. Now it's focusing on being a STEM ambassador. And the role of these ambassadors is to go out into schools and colleges and promote what a fantastic industry construction is to work in and what a good company Willmott Dixon is to work for. And there are a number of trainees in the business who've been nominated for our Construction and STEM Ambassador of the Year Award. This year's nominations are Gabriella Caruso, London and East, Isla Clapperton, London and South, Jane Cottam, North, Fionn Jones, Wales and West, Chloe Willacombe, Interiors. All of our nominees have put a fantastic effort in. They've spent many hours volunteering, organising, working in partnership with schools and other educational establishments to inspire the next generation. This year's winner has gone above and beyond. They've really gone the extra mile. They created work booklets to supplement and enhance work experience placements, and they developed and successfully ran 3 future talent programs for female students. So I'm delighted to announce this year's winner is Gabriella Caruso. Gabriella, this trophy will be on its way to you shortly. So now it's time to find out who will be crowned Trainee of the Year. You know, we're always asked what we look for in our Trainee of the Year. What we're looking for is someone who's straightforward, plain talking, who can find the simplest solution to a problem. Someone who is humble and open-minded enough to listen to different points of view. Someone who wakes up in the morning and says, you know what, I think I can do better today what I did yesterday. So today is about recognising the trainee that has all of these attributes and stands out from the crowd. Now, when Rick and I carried out the interviews back in January, we were extremely impressed with all the finalists. So this year, the decision has been one of the most difficult ever. The competition was fierce, but ultimately, there can only be one winner. We will now show you a short video of each finalist in turn so you can get to know them a bit better.
My name's Tom Armstrong-Jones. I'm an assistant building manager and I work for London and East. I've always wondered when I was a child how a building actually comes together. So I've always had a passion for construction, and I just thought being a site manager, you get to manage that whole process. Regarding Willmott Dixon, I feel that they are striding above the rest at everything they do, so environmentally, community engagement. Yeah, I just think they're one of the best companies in the UK. My desk. I always want a spotless desk. And quite a lot of people, they wind me up every morning I come in. They always put in something else on my desk.
Have you got a message for them?
Yeah. Don't do it, please. I did dress up as Ivor Goodsight. It was at school. I was walking down a ever narrowing corridor of children, and whoever's wore the actual suit, they'll know that you've got these size 30 plus boots on, and I ended up tripping over one of the children. So.
Was the child okay?
I hope so. Yeah, no, I carried on like a pro, but yeah. So I think I'm very determined, and I think that's what you need as a building manager. Very organised, I've got a bit of OCD. People skills as well, so I like going out there, I like talking to the guys on site.
Tom stands out from the crowd for his perseverance and determination. He's absolutely driven to transform his life and succeed. He joined us actually from Bedford College as a work experience placement, and he came for 1 week, and 3 months later we had to say, it's about time you went back to college. And he had stayed all that time working for free. We got to learn that in the background he was actually working early mornings and late nights and weekends at Tesco's to fund his rent, his college and his life. Part of his journey really is that he's come from being a exuberant youth, shall we say, to a caring young man, and that journey has been an amazing journey for him. He's transformed his life in his time with us.
I did say to my director when he first asked me 5 years ago, where do you see yourself in 5 years' time? And I actually replied to him and said, in your shoes. So I know it's going to take more than 5 years, but hopefully one day I may be in his shoes.
I'm AJ Banger and I'm an assistant project surveyor at Willmott Dixon Interiors in Farringdon. I think what really struck me about Willmott Dixon is how it's friendly, like family run. Everyone, as soon as I came in for the interview, was really friendly, smiley, introduced themselves. It just made me feel sort of quite relaxed, obviously nervous to start with, so it was nice. I would say that sort of I've always got on with people, sort of quite friendly. Maths based obviously helped me as a surveyor, and just comfortable talking to people and stuff like that, really. So I always crack my neck. I'm like, always crack my neck all the time. My trainee and everyone always looks at me and tells me to stop it, and I just can't do it, it's habit.
Yeah. Oh!
Yeah. Sorry, Mel.
Great in headphones.
I don't know if I have a speciality, but I do a good roast. It always ends up being my job on a Sunday to do a roast. So, yeah, Mum's going to miss that one when I leave. Cool. So basically, when I was younger, me and my brother were in the garden and my mum had just got these new plant pots. So I thought it'd be funny to put it on my head. I didn't realise it actually got stuck. And my mum thought she was going to have to call the fire brigade to get it off. So it's like this ceramic plant pot. I was walking around the garden with it on my head. So yeah, my brother doesn't let me forget that one, unfortunately.
How did you get out?
I think my mum had to pull it off me and it was quite painful. I think back in the summer, back in June, I went to Ghana. I volunteered for a construction and renovation programme that was sponsored and sort of promoting Willmott Dixon. I think that's the biggest thing for me. It was quite a humbling experience, which I really enjoyed.
There's a few things about AJ that I just think are great. I think as an individual, he's very passionate. He's just got a natural enthusiasm about him. He just actively promotes not only the business, but the industry. So he's been involved with a number of events, trying to attract new people into the business. And I think the one thing that really stands out for me is he took a week out of his summer to go to Ghana, to work with the local community, to create a new space for teachers who had been traveling for 2 to 3 hours a day each way for overnight accommodation. And I think that just really sums up AJ. He's so passionate about helping people.
I think one of the good things about sort of working at Willmott Dixon is sort of when you come in, hopefully at the end of the day, you feel a bit proud when you go home. And when you walk past previous projects, I mean, I've done it sort of back to sort of projects in London that I've worked on recently in LSA. When you walk past a project and people are like, wow, that looks really good. And there's a bit of pride in you. Like, I built that job or I worked on that project. And the fact that you're working to hopefully like improve the lives of other people and stuff, it's not just a job. Like, you enjoy it and you do it for a reason, and it means something to you at the end of the day when you go home. I think that's what's most rewarding about it.
My name is Hussein Izzet and I'm IT Project Manager and I work for Holdings. So when I was younger, my dad owned a construction company, and ever since I was really young, I've always been interested in how things worked. So how nuts and bolts worked, how buildings went up, how things were secure and safe. So ever since I was young, I've always been interested in construction. And obviously my older sister, she was in IT. So I was always interested in how things worked and a technical background. So those two things brought together brought me Willmott Dixon. So Lord Sugar would be somebody that inspires me, just for his passion and his drive from a young age to continue to drive and to become successful. I'll be a dog because of my desire to help others and also taking the lead, quite literally, in my projects day to day. I knew that was gonna happen. That's good, right? Every week, I'll choose somebody in the office to plug in my keyboard, wireless keyboard, and when they start working, I'll start typing from the other end. So they'll just think something's going wrong, but it'll just be me pressing delete for a couple of minutes. Being a project manager is very stressful, obviously. It's always about time, quality, cost. So bringing that bit of my humour into it, a bit of my personality, and bringing that relationship focus into it really helps. So getting people to be on the same page as you and being happy to work with you is really important. So I think the relationships come first in order to deliver a really, really, really successful project.
I think what makes Hussein stand out from the crowd is his drive and determination. You know, he's like a human dynamo when he goes at anything. And most specifically, he's been delivering infrastructure projects. These infrastructure projects are absolutely critical to our business. So for all those people who have recognised that their network speed has got faster or their server problems have been sorted out, all those sorts of things, that's all down to Hussein. He's not just taking part in these projects, he's leading them and delivering them. And if I was to want to find an example of someone who embodies our values, our behaviours, then Hussein would be the one. You know, he absolutely nails it.
So my aims are to bridge the gap between IT and the business. So I think we need to start putting more of a IT initiative into the business and use more technology in construction to not just make it safer, but to also continue being the market leader. Yeah, I would like to say a huge thank you to everyone for everyone's support. Because when I came into the company, I was nervous, obviously. You don't know how to, do you ask silly questions? Do you not ask the silly questions? But everyone's very, very friendly. So asking those questions actually helps me develop further and understand what things are right and what things are wrong. So that's really helped.
Jack Hall, Assistant Building Manager, working out the Northern office.
Is it the Northern or the North?
Can I repeat that? So I'm Jack Hall, Assistant Building Manager, working out the office North. So I'm Jack Hall, Assistant Building Manager, working for Construction North. When I joined Willmott Dixon, I was a 18-year-old school leaver. I was very young, a bit immature, and I just got thrown in at the deep end, really. So as I progressed through the ranks and progressed from project to project, I suppose I've just grew up and learned an awful lot about construction, but learned an awful lot about myself, really, which yeah, can only be a positive. Probably say my promotion to Assistant Building Manager, just to look back and the 5 years that I've been with Willmott Dixon, just to be promoted and look back on how I've progressed in my career, but also how I've progressed as a person.
Jack, for me, epitomises what we look for in a Willmott Dixon person. He was promoted to Assistant Building Manager in September, and he's due to be working on our largest project in Manchester, which starts next year, Manchester College. People are desperately trying to get him on their projects. He is that much of an asset that people want him as part of their team. He's humble. He's hardworking and he's a fabulous team player.
For probably have to say, just try everything and take every opportunity that you get offered. There's so many brilliant opportunities out there working for Willmott Dixon, and yeah, just do everything and try and experience everything. I wanted to be a policeman. I'll probably have to say Mustafa from Lion King, and that's because he's fair, but also firm at the same time. Food. Food's one of my passions. My mum's homemade lasagna. It's brilliant, it's gorgeous. Yeah, I'd just like to thank everybody that who have contributed to my career. I've worked with so many brilliant line managers, so many brilliant colleagues. Yeah, I'd just like to thank everybody who's contributed to the assistant building manager that I am today. And I couldn't have done it without my colleagues and people at Willmott Dixon.
So I'm Jordan Race and I'm an Assistant Community Manager at the Midlands LCL. It is just everything happens for a reason. Going through my trainee programme, I went through a phase where I didn't know what I wanted to do. And I literally just went into every single placement completely open-minded, even to the fact that construction might not actually be for me. And then something switched halfway through and a member of the community team actually left and went into a different role in the company, which then opened the gap for me to join the team. And I've realised that it's actually what I want to do, and I just clicked and did it. I think my proudest moment is when I had that final interview with the managing director and he said, right, you're ready for promotion. And it was just like after the last 4.5 years of hard work, tears, laughter, everything that's gone into the trainee programme, somebody finally believed in me and said, you know what, yeah, you're ready. Slobbing out on the sofa on a Friday night knowing I haven't got to get up the day after with a big tub of ice cream, Ben and Jerry's cookie dough, and literally just watching all the soaps. I look forward to the soaps on a Friday night because you've got them one after another. The team that are around me, they've supported me coming into the role that I'm doing with no background at all, no qualifications, no experience. And honestly, after the 2 years in that particular role, I feel like I could conquer it all.
We nominated Jordan for Trainee of the Year because she's really the genuine article. Everything she does to the next level. So community, that's her present role is. She's this community. She lives and breathes it, and she wants to bring betterment to everybody she works with. Whatever role she takes on from when she started as an apprentice at 16, every department has fed back superbly. So I think overall, the genuine article, being keen to do more than required, and just really a people person, and helping the Salvation Army convert an old building into a training centre. And you just don't realise how many people can't even afford a bus fare to get to a place of work. So having a training centre on their doorstep was fantastic for her, the community, and the house where she helped the Salvation Army. So things like that, she has really delivered, not only for herself and the business, but really a legacy for the community overall.
So I'd say to sign up to everything that you get sent. Don't worry about doing too many courses or being off site too much or whatever. Do as much as you can and take full advantage of anything that's given to you as a trainee.
My name is Charlotte and I'm an assistant bid coordinator. A lot of my family work in construction, so they first recommended getting into construction, and I at first was like, no way. But the more I learned about it, the more I understood the industry, the more sort of excited I got about the prospect of working in construction and saw that there was a place for me. I love the construction industry now. I couldn't actually imagine doing anything different. When I was 5 years old, I wanted to be a teacher. Always wanted to be a teacher. I love coaching people, I love helping people, and I think the trainee scheme has let me do that because I've always helped the new trainees settle in and I've always been somebody for them to go to. So I'm the mum trainee, so. I love to cook, so any sort of hosting I can do. Signature dish, I love cooking Thai, so love a good curry. I'm a leg jigger. I jig my leg and it drives people mental. So for me, being a trainee, the best bit was just getting involved with all the different experiences. You get to experience so much as a trainee that you never get to experience as like a normal employee.
Most people will have now heard about Building Lives Academy. The very first one was actually Charlotte's inspiration, really, to push that through with the team. And it was her tenacity that made that come true. And without that sort of example, you're not really going to move things forward. So congratulations to Charlotte for that. She was also a member of our Team of the Year with Ada, but also a member of our Project of the Year with Heathfield last year. So real instrumental trainee that wherever she goes, she makes a difference.
Thank you to everyone who's been a part of my journey. Without all the support and time that everyone's given me, I wouldn't be here today. So. The advice I'd give any new trainee is to make the most of every opportunity, but overall just enjoy it, enjoy every second of it.
Very worthy finalists there, I'm sure you'll agree. Our winner will receive a cheque for £1,000 together with the opportunity to enjoy a celebratory event with their family, observing the rule of six. I'm delighted now to hand you back to Rick Willmott, who will announce our Trainee of the Year.
Every year it is a really difficult decision to select our winning trainee, as the finalists are so worthy of their place on the shortlist. But after much deliberation, I can tell you that this year's winner has been chosen because of their tenacity, attitude and drive. They have overcome adversity in their early career. They put themselves through college whilst working for a supermarket, joining us initially for a week's work experience that lasted for 3 months, and now have not only graduated from our trainee programme, but also secured a first-class degree. This individual has shown sheer determination and perseverance throughout to become a highly valued member of our management trainee community. I'm delighted to announce that the Trainee of the Year is Tom Armstrong-Jones from Construction, London and East.
Like a bull in a glass house, no bull about to smash out. Can't nothing stand in my way.
Well done, Tom. Fantastic job. My congratulations go to you and all our other finalists. I can't finish without thanking the team who've pulled all of this together. My thanks go to Eclipse and Ember, who put the videos and staging together for the virtual event, to Mark Robinson from Scape, Rick Willmott, our Group Chief Executive, and to Sally Cleaver, Claire Williams and Mel Abrook from my team at Letchworth for their fantastic work behind the scenes in organising this event, pulling all the different threads together. And to all of you for joining with us and celebrating virtually. I hope you'll agree that, you know, despite the fact it's been a very different Trainee of the Year, it's been another fantastic celebration in terms of the achievements of Tom, our finalists, and all our trainees across the group. Despite the challenging circumstances that we find ourselves in, we're confident that with you, our trainees, as our future leaders, The prospects for the company look very bright indeed. I would like to wish you all the best for your careers with Willmott Dixon, and I hope that you have the career of a lifetime. Thank you. We'll be right back.